In this video, we will discuss mean reversion and Z-score. Mean reversion suggests that prices, or various economic indicators, tend to move around the historical average, or mean. Trading strategies, based on this theory, involve the purchase or a sale of a financial instrument, whose recent performance is very different from its historical average. Let us consider this example. Every day, the price of gold rises or falls by say 5 Indian rupees to 15 Indian rupees. One day, it rises by 30 Indian rupees. If there is no significant reason behind this rise, then as per the mean reversion principle, it is expected that the gold prices will fall down. A mean reversionist would sell gold. On the other hand, say if the gold prices had suddenly fallen down one day by 30 Indian rupees, then the mean reversion strategy would have been to buy gold, expecting the prices to go up. Now, let us look at the concept of Z-score. Z-scores indicates that the number of standard deviations the prices from the mean. The Z-score shows numerically how the different members in a group differ from the mean of the group. Z-score is calculated using the given formula. To understand how a Z-score is calculated, please refer to the glossary section. For example, the Z-score of gold can indicate when a trade is to be executed. If the Z-score of gold rises above the upper threshold value, then sell the gold expecting the price to fall back towards the mean value. Similarly, when it falls below the lower threshold value, then buy the gold. Positive Z-score indicates that the price is above the mean, while a negative Z-score demonstrates the price to be below the mean. A Z-score of 0 indicates the price is exactly equal to the population mean. To sum it up, we learned about the mean reversion principle, which suggests that prices tend to move around the historical mean over time, and Z-scores can be used to identify the deviation from the mean and generate the appropriate trading signals. That is all for this video. In the upcoming unit, there are quizzes based on these concepts, and then we will learn about cointegration.